Hey everyone, today I'm going to make a tutorial about the super fast elevator that brings you from bottom to sky limit in under 1 second. So me and Method spent a lot of time on it to make it more compact, and this is a changed version compared to the version we showed 2 days ago. And let's just check it out. So it's also now more convenient to use. It's going to game mode zero, step on the pressure plate, click on Nayama, and there we are at world limit. Then just press left shift to get off the Yama, and the Yama is sent back down. Methods, could you also use the elevator?
Yeah, as soon as the Yama
is
here.
Takes a while to fall down. And there we go. So just has to get off and step out, and this block is retracted. It releases the Yama back again. Also got a lot of questions how if you could make an elevator downwards elevator, not with this design, because you only get teleported on top of the farmland, but you could always use chorus fruits to get back down again. So if you block all possible teleportation spots, you're down instantly. Okay, now I'll start doing the tutorial in case you're interested in building this. First I do the bottom station, then the middle part, which is highly repetitive, and last the station at the top. What's kind of important is that this piston here with the armor stand for each subchunk has to be on a boundary. So if you press F3 and G, you get those blue lines which indicate the subchunk boundaries. And this piston armor stand, they have to be either at this height, so directly at the border, or one block lower. Okay, one block higher wouldn't work. So each of those two cases, and of course it depends at which Y value you start, where you need to place the piston. Also the direction of those butt chains changes every second layer, so you also might need to mirror this station here. But I'll show you how to build this differently with the tutorial elevator, so you can check out the world download for both cases. Hey, let's get rid of those lines again, and I built this one 3 blocks higher than this one. So we start with the pressure plate that you step on. Once you release the pressure, then the elevator would start. I use the iron pressure plate here because it turns off quicker than the normal wooden pressure plate. Okay, now we need a repeater and a non-movable block. I use for the non-movable blocks terracotta, but obsidian or something similar would also work. Here we need redstone dust and a non-movable block again, and a torch, sticky piston, and upwards facing observer, and a block on top. Here we can already place some blocks, so the water that will hydrate the farmland will flow down right there. So we'll place a block bottom. So it's contained in here. Next, let's add a repeater here. Points into a block, and another repeater there. This one is on 2 ticks. Then another block. And now we go up a little bit, like this. And 1, 2, 3, 4 redstone dust, comparator in the middle for the pulse extender. Then we put another repeater on 2 ticks on top of this block. We should power a rail that in turn updates a sticky piston. Then place 3 slime blocks in front of the sticky piston and meanwhile add this block here. Then we can also add a sticky piston right here and place a slime block. Okay, now let's go over to this side again. You just need to add some redstone dust. You put down another sticky piston for observer in front. And here we need another sticky piston for the farmland. Yeah, for now, of course, obviously use dirt or grass. We will hoe all the dirt or grass once we're finished, when the water is in, otherwise it would turn back into dirt if you don't hydrate it. So next, get a cobble wall, place it in front of the pressure plate, and another block next to the extended piston arm, and also place a cobble wall on top. And we build a little water channel for the Yama to get back in position. So something like this. and put in the water. So the Yama will be flushed up this block. So we just step up and yeah, remain this position here. So the Yama could still escape to the side when he's standing on this block. That's why he plays another normal block here and there. And even another one there. And here we put a rail on top. This has the advantage, it's useful for the transport system. I actually required a rail here, and also the Yama wouldn't pathfind on top of a rail. Okay, now let's also put in some blocks to guide the Yama, it doesn't run out side of those blocks. Put in a block here, and maybe some glass blocks actually, so you can see it, just to encase the drop chute. So like this. Could also put a little arch on top. It's just important to have another non-movable block, and this would be your entrance. I'll grab a normal piston and place it here. Also get a carpet and place it on top of the slime block. Let's continue on this side, place another sticky piston and three slime blocks. And already this block here. And now the next sticky piston right here. Then make this little L shape there, put a dirt here, and here we need another two non-movable blocks and place a rail here. Then attach an observer pointing in that direction. In front, a repeater on three ticks pointing into a block, and here a sticky piston with a downwards facing observer. So now the repetitive part will start. Don't forget to put the carpet on top of this first slime block in front of the sticky piston. And I'll just alternate every second block the direction of the sticky piston. Put three slime blocks in front and a block there. And here we also alternate position. So right, left, right, left. Next one is here. Always make this L shape. The carpet on top of the first slime block. Put the dirt here for now, and the rail into two blocks there. Okay, so the next one will be here. Let's do another one, carpet, dirt. Actually, here you don't need to use non-movable blocks. The normal ones would do. Just here needs some. Okay, now the station that you need every 16 blocks is next. Has to be in a chunk border, so let's check again. So build this up until the first blue line. So build this up to this point. Here's the chunk border line. And don't place a block to update the sticky piston above. Instead, place it on the side. In case it's different for you, because I built it up different Y value, then you can also check it here. So it's just one block higher. Okay, in case it's you started two blocks lower, then you could also do the same, just the other direction. Then everything's mirrored what I do next. Okay, now next step is we need to add another block there and piston on the side. Then we need a slab here and there, and here another block. And below, we place a comparator, back a cauldron, just fill up with water. And we put in the redstone dust. And here we place down a button to redirect the redstone dust so it doesn't power this piston here. Let's update it again, so now it's no longer powered. Okay, so the next step, we need a cobble wall again. Because we need to align the next armor stand. So put it on top of the sticky, the normal piston and push it against the cobble wall. Remove the piston again. Now I can also remove the cobble wall. Damn it. Do that again, I guess. Okay. So remove the cobble wall. And then I can place another redstone dust on top of this block. Okay, then we need tripwire hooks. One, two, three. non-movable block actually here. Attach the hooks. And Armistead obviously will activate the string here. It's getting pushed up. This is how we get the one game tick delay. Then we need another non-movable block right there. And we place a rail on top to update this part. Okay, in the back we place a repeater on three ticks, pointing to a block and a normal piston right there that pushes the stuff back that I'm about to build. So we need also a slab. And this prevents or limits the armor stand, how far the armor stand is getting pushed up. Then here another slime block and a block there. Okay, so that's the chaining station that you need every 16 blocks from now on. Here, basically do the same again, go left, right, and build this up. Okay, so I'm gonna stop the elevator right there. Obviously, it's only worth it to build this fast elevator, which is a bit more complicated if you really want to cover a large distance. But yeah, for the sake of the tutorial, let's stop right there. So here, the last skip piston has to face in that direction, and you only need to have one slime block in front and a normal block. Okay, so on top of the sticky piston, place a block and another one right there. Then non-mover blocks here and there. And now you can put in the water. Just get a bucket, let it flow down. You can also grab a hoe now and turn all the dirt into farmland. Okay, that's it. If you want, you can also put in the butts now, or activate them by placing the redstone blocks. Okay, this should cover it. Now grab another sticky piston and place him right there. Upwards facing of server in front, and then you need to get a dropper and place it here. Then next to it, two blocks, dust and repeater on top. The repeater on three ticks of delay points into a block, then a sticky piston on top and a slime block, and this actually shoots the armor over. Then repeater, block, two repeaters, and block with dust on top, powering another sticky piston. And now we just need some glass blocks, which would prevent the armor from wandering back later. Okay, then we can continue on this side here. Two observers on top of the dropper, block, slabs, and three repeaters on top on max delay. So they power this block here with dust. And on the side, a sticky piston and a downwards facing observer. Then below, some redstone dust on top of a block. Then just go over. You can actually place the repeater here. Block, non-movable block. Compare it in between. Block on top and redstone dust. So another pulse extender. On the side we put the torch and once more sticky piston, just powered by the torch here, and just some a block there. This is the block that retracts and lets the armor fall down. So you can already see there's the water below. Okay, now let's also add a slab here. Okay. This powers a hopper. Hopper so it doesn't suffocate anyone. And on top, server. And go over. And power those rails here. That would update the sticky piston later. Okay, so just place a block here. Then some tripwire hook. And add a string. And now I have to look it up again. One small correction, the sticky piston block has to be lowered by one, sorry. Okay, now let's continue here. So basically here we need to lock the Yammer in so it doesn't walk off or escape somehow. So place leaf blocks here so they don't suffocate the player, also don't stick to the slime block, that's why leaves. Then also get some glass blocks and fill this up a little bit. So this keeps the player and the Yammer safe in there. This. Let's also do the exit. So also again a little arch. If you want to, could also use glass blocks and here a trapdoor. Sometimes the Yama or the entity glitch a little bit and then you suffocate in blocks. So that's why I'm a little bit careful here if you're using solid blocks, but it should be fine. Minecraft is sometimes a little bit buggy with that stuff, especially if you send an entity with almost the speed of sound upwards. Okay, anyway, let's fill this up a little bit. Also some blocks here and there, also on top of the string. So this should cover it. And we are actually done here with filling this up now. Yeah. Place some blocks to step outside. And let's check it again. So the armor goes up here, shot over by the slime block. Then it's held right there. This glass block extends, preventing it from walking back. The player activates the string. Once the player gets off the armor, you need to press forward to step out. And then a little bit later, the block retracts, the armor falls straight down. One correction, the glass block that's supposed to be placed here, was grabbed by the slime block, this shouldn't happen. Place a leaf there instead. Let's also build a little drop chute for the Yammer. So I'll place some non-movable blocks against the slime blocks there. Okay, and fill up the rest. Glass blocks. Okay, that should do it. Now let's actually get the tamed Yama in. Maybe remove those blocks and let's get the Yama. Okay, it's grown one, hay bales, tame it. Let's push it in actually. You can also tame it when it's in place. Okay, let's get on the Yama. Alright, let's get off again. Now we can try it out. Hope it works. Step on the pressure plate, on the Yama, and there we go. We're up. Get off the Yama, and it's sent back down again. And the next player could use the elevator. See, the Yama also steps up. Okay, that's it. Hope you enjoy this elevator. Hope it doesn't get fixed too soon, I guess. Until 1.13, we hopefully have at least 2 or 3 more months, and maybe Mojang doesn't even fix this. I mean, what's the point in fixing this? Everybody that uses it enjoys it, and there's really no downside for everybody else. Okay, thanks a lot for watching. Have a nice day. Bye bye.